Students, today we are going to learn about non-renewable energy resources. Energy is the measure of prosperity of any nation. The energy demand is growing day by day. The per capita use of energy by Americans is 24 times more than Indians. The world's demand for the electricity has almost doubled in the last 20 years. Energy resources can be classified into two main groups, non-renewable energy resources and renewable energy resources. So today we will explore non-renewable energy resources in detail. The resources of energy which cannot be replenished immediately or which cannot be regenerated immediately are known as non-renewable energy resources. They mainly include coal, oil, and natural gas. They are also called fossil fuels. So let us study them one by one. First of all, coal. It is primary source of energy. It is a solid fossil fuel with high calorific value. Coal can be found in different grades. Man has exploited more than 200 billion tons of coal out of 6,000 billion tons present in the earth crust. About 5% of world's coal is present in India. The coal reserves are mainly found in Bihar, Odisha, Jharkhand, West Bengal, MP and Maharashtra. There are many advantages of the coal. It is primary source of energy. It is used for cooking and heating in the domestic sector. It is used in thermal power plants to produce electricity. Coal is used to run the trains as fuel. It is also used for heating purposes in industries. But there are certain limitations of the coal. It has led to the harmful effects on the environment. Coal is bulky in size, so it is not easy to transport. The mining and transportation cost of coal is high. The burning of coal produces large amount of unburnt carbon particles, which leads to air pollution. The carbon dioxide produced after the burning of the coal leads to global warming. The sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide gases released after the burning of the coal causes acid rain in the environment. Next is oil or the petroleum. After the certain limitations in the coal, man led to the discovery of oil. It is a liquid fossil fuel. It is also called liquid coal. The crude oil or the petroleum is dark brown viscous liquid containing hydrocarbons. There are limited oil reserves in India and the world. Oil reserves are mainly located in Assam, Digboi, Cambay, that is Gujarat, and Bombay Highway. The liquid oil after the distillation can lead to the formation of many byproducts like petrol, diesel, LPG, bitumen, etc. So there are many advantages of the oil. It serves as the main fuel for the transport vehicles, that is to run cars, buses, trucks, trains, airplanes and jet planes, etc. The oil is more efficient fuel than the coal. It is easy to transport. It is very convenient to use. It is cleaner fuel than the coal. But there are certain limitations of the oil also. Although oil is known as liquid gold, but oil reserves are limited in India as well as in the world. So automobile exhaust has become the main source of air pollution, rather major source of air pollution due to incomplete combustion of the oil. The combustion of petrol and diesel produces carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide, which leads to air pollution as well as causes acid rain, and carbon monoxide may lead to the unconsciousness also. The natural gas, due to the certain limitations of the oil and the coal man led to the discovery of natural gas. It is a gaseous fossil fuel. Natural gas is a mixture of methane, propane, and the ethane. Natural gas reserves are mainly located in the basins of Krishna, Godavari, and Kaveri rivers in Gujarat and Bombay. There are many advantages of natural gas. It is a clean and efficient fuel than the coal and oil. It causes very less air pollution. It can be easily compressed into CNG, that is compressed natural gas. It can be used to run the vehicles. Use of CNG in vehicles has greatly reduced the air pollution in Delhi in India. The natural gas is also used as an industrial raw material in the photochemical industry and fertilizer industry. But certain limitations of the natural gas are there. The natural gas reserves are also limited. It is highly inflammable. Its leakage can lead to very serious accidents. So, although coal is solid fossil fuel, oil is liquid fossil fuel, and the natural gas is gaseous fossil fuel, all of them, they are non-renewable resources of energy. Means they cannot be regenerated or replenished immediately. They have to be exhausted one day. So, there is need to use these resources very, very judiciously. Judicious or efficient use of the non-renewable energy resources can run them for certain years. So, they should be used only and only where they are actually required. But there is need to exploit renewable sources of energy also. In the end, we can conclude, although non-renewable energy resources should be used only at the places where they can be only used, but there is a need to explore renewable energy resources like hydroelectric power, solar energy, biomass energy, wind energy, ocean energy, tidal energy, and geothermal energy. So, there are many alternative sources of energy. Future resources of energy like alcohol, hydrogen energy, and fuel cells should be also explored. So, we can run the energy, particularly renewable resources of energy in India, especially solar energy and biomass energy, are of great use to the mankind. I hope you must have liked this video. Kindly share it with your friends. Thank you. Thank you so much.